you already stated that Quran is clear.
Clear.
I ask you Quranic verse, you couldn't explain. I ask you about Muhammad, you can't explain. I am asking you very basics, you can't explain. What is it? Can you explain? Can you explain me the Tawhid?
Tawhid.
Tawhid, yeah. Oneness of Allah. Do you believe?
Tawhid.
Tawhid, yeah. Oneness of Allah. So do I want him to tell me. I want him to tell me. Do you believe? Do you believe the sifats of Allah? Sifats of Allah. Are they part of Allah,
yeah,
or they are separated from Allah? So, for example, is the word of Allah part of Allah or separated from Allah? Is the womb of Allah is part of Allah or is separated from Allah?
I don't understand this very I cannot my
Allah's Rahim.
Yeah.
So Allah has a Rahim. Allah has a Rahim.
Yeah.
Is the ruh of, womb of Allah, Rahim of Allah is separated from Allah or is it part of Allah?
Rahim is adjective. It's not part of it's adjective. It
okay,
is
so
adjective.
So womb of Allah is separated from Allah.
No, it is not. There is two.
Is the womb of Allah, which is Rahim, okay? Is it part of Allah or separated from Allah?
Can you show me that, please?
Allah, Rahim also meaning womb.
Rahim?
Says,
do you
Rahim,
speak Arabic?
Yeah. Rahim too meaning.
Yeah.
No,
you. I'm not talking about Bismillah Rahman Rahim one. I'm talking about the Rahim womb, okay? You never heard of it?
You can't speak Arabic.
I'm Turkish, sir. I don't speak Arabic.
Okay, can you show me in Arabic?
I'll show it to you, sir. So do you believe...
Yeah.
Focus. So you say, womb of Allah is separated from Allah.
Allah Ta'ala doesn't need any organ or something.
Oh, Allah doesn't need a womb?
No, nothing.
But Allah has a womb. I am not asking does he need it or he doesn't need it. I am not asking you that. I am asking, is the womb of Allah separated from Allah or is it the part of Allah?
Two meaning. Rahim means two meaning. One is
No. I am asking Rahim as a womb. Rahim is the Turkish.
Okay, but two also maybe the Rahim is the
No, I am not asking. I am not asking that one.
No,
I am asking the Turkish womb is the womb of Allah, is part of Allah or separated from Allah.
I am saying different thing. Rahim also, as you said, womb part of.
I am talking about that one.
Yeah, okay. Allah, I am not explaining. Allah Ta'ala doesn't need any organ or thing. Allah Ta'ala doesn't.
I hear what you are saying. Allah doesn't need organs. Okay?
Doesn't
need organs. Can we just move on with it? Because this can all spill out over onto us.
You've got everything.
But I am asking, does Allah, okay? It's not about he does need it. It's not about does he need it or not. I am asking, is it part of Allah or is it separated from Allah?
One of the Allah Ta'ala is Rahim.
People like you are doing it
Rahim.
My back. Because you never know when you try to touch my ass.
Rahim is the one of the
going.
Why are you following me? Get your head out of my ass.
Thanks, sir.
Get away from my ass. I'm not king.
Okay. Are you listening?
Rahim
so, Surah 47, Surah 47, verse 22.
Which surah?
Surah 47, verse 22.
No name 47.
That's the number of the surah?
No. The number of the
Surah 47, verse 22. Okay? Surah 47, in your language, would be...
No Quran, there is no Surah 47.
Surah Muhammad. Surah 47?
I'm sure, there is no Surah 47.
Surah 47? Surah 47?
Just let me see.
Okay. Surah 47? Got it? Okay?
Okay.
So, John, listen. Surah 47 verse 22. I am asking very basic question about, is the womb of Allah separated from Allah or the part of Allah? According to this gentleman, he says Allah doesn't need a womb. That's not what I am asking. Allah already has a womb, okay? Womb is the place where like babies develop, all that part, okay? So Allah already has it. I wanted to ask if it is part of Allah or it is separated from Allah. I didn't ask, oh, does Allah need organ donation? I didn't ask that. I am simply asking about the womb of Allah, and then I will be asking some questions on that. So, Surah 47 verse 22, I read it the background to you, and then I'm going to bring up the tafsir, okay?
No, I'm explaining, you don't listen to me. There is two meaning of the Rahim.
I am asking about the womb one.
You don't listen to me what I'm saying. Two different meaning.
So Rahim and Ra, Rahim. So one of them is womb. Okay?
Yeah,
I am asking about the womb.
Yeah, okay.
Womb of Allah. Okay?
Yeah,
Allah has a womb. No. If you want, I'll show you the picture of it.
Allah does. Egypt is the other meaning. The other meaning, not womb. You are just, that's why I'm telling you. This womb is, as you said, one of the meaning is womb in Turkish, maybe Arabic as well, I don't know. The other meaning, Rahim is adjective of Allah Ta'ala. What is the meaning of the
most
Rahim?
Merciful, most gracious.
Mercy.
Okay, so is this
forgiving?
Okay, then let me read it to Hadith, and then you explain it to me, okay?
Yeah, okay.
Muhammad said, Allah created the creation, and when he finished from his creation, the womb got up and said to it, stop. What do you want, it said. At this place, I seek refuge with you from all those who sever me. Allah said, would you be pleased that I will keep good relation with the one who will keep good relation with you. I will sever the relation with the one who will sever the relation with you. It is said, yes, oh my Lord. Allah said, this is for you. Then Abu Huraira recited Surah 47, verse 22. So if the Rahim, okay, mercy in this occasion, why is the mercy of Allah is speaking to Allah? In here, he's the Arabic. Do you read Arabic? So this is Sahih Bukhari. John, Sahih Bukhari, 7502 hadith number. Okay, sir, can you read the can you read it for me? Actually, read it for him. Is it talking about the womb of Allah? Is it translation for you?
No. Just can I hold it?
No, you can't hold it. I'll hold it. It's in the first line, first or second line.
It says, I create the Rahim.
Yeah.
But not inside me.
Listen. John, where is Rahim? The one inside you. Womb. Are you with us? Come to her.
Two meaning.
No. Listen. He's Arabic speaker. What is it?
Yeah.
It is the one inside you. Okay?
Mercy is another meaning.
No, not that one. Listen him. He's Arabic speaker. And also look at the translation. In the translation, it is translated as the womb of Allah.
Rahim.
Okay? Not Rahim. Look at here.
Not Rahim. Womb. Mercy.
Womb.
Rahim. It's another meaning.
Yeah, two meaning. But Allah Ta'ala is the adjective.
Before you were born, when you was. You was your mom bully.
I know. It's
what's
meaning.
Inside your mom bully?
Yeah.
So when you were inside your mommy's belly,
okay?
Yeah. That's Rahim. Where you were.
Yeah.
So Allah has that one. And that Rahim, that womb,
they call it in Arabic Rahim.
Okay, that womb speaks to Allah. Okay, so I've got the picture here. So this is Allah, this is the womb of Allah is speaking to Allah. So you said Allah doesn't need certain organs.
No,
I am asking, when Sahih Bukhari 7502 as the background for Surah 47 verse 22 talks about the womb of Allah, are they lying? Because it says womb of Allah speaks, okay, pulls down Allah and then says, I seek refuge from you.
My English and Turkish is not enough.
I don't
speak.
Tell me Turkish.
I need to know. Knowledge is not enough.
Tell me Turkish.
Your
English is not enough. Your Turkish is not enough. Your Arabic is not enough. Why don't you trust the translation?
I am telling. My knowledge is not enough. Maybe some alim, expert can explain.
We need the scholars again. Sir, I'll ask you a very basic question. The hadith which you read, okay, Sahih Bukhari, 7502, that's the reference. Identified already Sahih. Can you tell me why the womb of Allah is speaking with Allah and what is the problem womb is having? Why Allah at the first place has a womb which is separated from him?
I told you before that you have mistake.
And what is the mistake?
Yeah, I'm telling you. The first mistake I told you because you're using hadith.
Okay, and so my mistake is using the hadith.
Yeah.
I'm just making sure I understood, okay? Do your homework. It's not see you another time. I ask you very basic questions. You fail to answer all the very basic questions. Come back next time with proper answer. Because you know what? On the day of judgment, when you stand in front of God, who is going to judge you, you are not going to be able to say, oh, let me ask the alims, let me ask the scholars. Pull yourself together, think through, give up Islam, turn to Lord Jesus Christ. Yes, sir, make your case. You said, I have a mistake. First one is, I am reading the hadith. Second one?
Yeah, I said the first time, not the first one. First time you did a mistake when you used hadith.
Okay, and so using the hadith is a mistake,
just
okay?
No,
I'm just trying to make sure I hear correctly, because you've got mask.
Yeah, okay. And the mistake is you using the hadith.
Okay.
And there's a lot of Muslim people, they don't believe in hadith.
Okay, there are Muslims who don't believe in hadith.
A lot of Muslim people.
Okay.
Okay. But all of them, they believe in Quran.
Okay.
And you did the same mistake two times when you used the hadith.
Okay.
And the second time.
So my mistake is using the hadith. Okay, that's fine. My mistake is using the hadith. Let me just verbalize. My mistake is using the hadith because Muslims does reject the hadith, but they stick with the Quran, correct? They follow the Quran. There is no mistakes in the Quran according to you.
All of them, they follow the Quran.
Okay. Explain this to me because the hadith I read to you is for the Surah 47, verse 22. Can you explain Surah 47, verse 22 for me?
Believe me, there is no Surah 47.
Muhammad.
Just let me tell you something. I grown up in Iraq. I speak Arabic. I read all of this book. I know all of this Surah. There is no Surah 47.
Surah 47
is
also called Surah Muhammad, which I showed you.
Yeah, but
you
not
saw
Surah
by your
47.
Own eyes. So that's how we use in England. That's absolutely fine. It's Surah Muhammad, verse 22.
How can I know? The original book, it's not numbers, it's names.
Surah Muhammad, verse 22.
Okay, show me the Surah.
Explain this verse to me.
You have to know that there is no God, only one God. And say Astaghfirullah for the male mu'min and female mu'min. And God knows what you are doing, like this.
I want you to explain the verse to me.
Yeah.
Not translate it. I've got a translation.
Yeah.
I want you to explain it to me.
Yeah. Explain to me.
I am bringing. Why? I thought he can answer your question.
He can't answer.
Why not?
Because he doesn't know how to answer.
So what is the problem with this?
So, back. So if you explain this verse to me.
No, I'm waiting your explanation.
No. So I gave you the hadith,
yeah.
which is using this Quranic reference,
yeah.
as the background for the giving you the background for this Quranic verse.
Yeah.
So you are rejecting the hadith. You are telling me Muslims are rejecting the hadith. I want you to just explain this to me without hadith.
No.
Tell me
I
what
think
it.
There is misunderstanding between
okay.
me and you.
Yeah.
I explain to you that I'm ex-Muslim. I don't believe even in this book. But I'm telling you, when you...
Why are you ex-Muslim?